your name and what's your... I keep doing that. What's your name and what's your title, bro?
Okay. My name is Derek Murdoch. I'm Unclassified Perspectives Creative Director.
Okay, so what is Unclassified Perspectives?
I don't really want to go into that much right now because it's like we got the whole outside thing that we're doing for that. That's going to pretty much break down the channel. I want this to be more focused, you know, around me, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
I figured this is like my only chance because once you get up and cooking, you know, people are going to be having their own perspectives on who I am and what I'm about. I think I got one chance to actually tell people one-on-one, you know, who I am, you know, what I'm about. Mm-hmm. You know, the people are already trying to go crazy on me over here and it's like not even big yet and I'm already getting madness, so.
Got death threats, yo?
Not yet, you know what I'm saying? Not my first official death threat. I'm looking forward to it, though.
No.
You know what I'm saying?
No, we're not looking forward to that.
Nah, I'm looking forward to that. You'll bring all the hate, man. I got enough love in my life. I could take some hate.
No so, okay. So tell me about where you grew up.
For Rockaway, Queens. Wasn't born and raised there. I was born in Bamberg, South Carolina. My family moved up here. At first, they was in Brooklyn. Then they came to Far Rockaway. But I was living there since I was three. So that's like my hometown represent, you know?
Yeah, I was coming in and this guy was like, hey, you're going over there to shoot with Derek, huh? I was like, yeah. He's like, yeah, I like the pooper reel. I was like, oh, okay.
And probably was gone. You know what I'm saying? The tall guy beard,
yeah.
Tattoos, yeah, it's gone, mad cool. He's yeah. A gamer too. He'd be having all types of, he has the crazy gaming rig and stuff like that.
Okay, speaking of gaming, like how are you associated with gaming?
Man, come on, I've been playing video games all my life, man. I might be into politics and stuff like that, you know, that's my love, man. First love is music, second love is, you know what I'm saying, gaming and stuff like that, just for entertainment purposes and things like that. And after that is like news, politics, just information, things like that. You know me, P, I always like learning, you know what I'm saying? So as much as I could put in here, there's as much I'm gonna take, you know? And then we got the information age this day, they should never did that. Cause I be in my Audible listening to books all day. I be reading books all the time. I'm on YouTube checking any piece of information I can find out or any documentary backgrounds or anything like that. You know, I'm obsessed with it. So when I started building up all this extra knowledge and stuff like that, you know, I was like, you know, maybe I could do something with it. I'm always informing people, you know, like anytime it's like election year and stuff like that, people always tend to text me and be like, hey, who should I vote for? And my initial response to that in the beginning was like, why you don't know? And, you know, I realized that was the wrong approach. You know, not everybody has the time or is intrigued with this as I am. So if I give them a little answer, give point them in the right direction, you know, that's all good. And that's kind of like what this is all about, you know what I'm saying? Just me sharing information, you know. Some people have selective sources where they get their information from. They like, they might not want to take it from certain people. So maybe they'll take some from me. You know, I can just put it out there and see what happens, you know? Mm-hmm. Make a little bit of a difference, it's fine by me. I'm not trying to change the world, just trying to give my input, you know?
Give your perspective.
There you go. Oh, you worked it in. I like that.
Got it.
I like that.
Picking up on it. That's what's up.
Mm.
Okay, so.
Keeping up on it. Keeping up on it. See, it works all the time.
Word.
I'm going to be kicking punts all day.
Nice.
All
right. Mm-hmm. Okay, so with this channel, what are the topics? What are the type of things you're going to be talking about? Are we talking about like music and politics?
Yeah,
it's talking about Jussie. Who we talking about?
We're gonna be talking about a little of everything. The content that I'm trying to really concentrate on, I'm trying to try and make it timeless the best that I can. Right about now, I'm a nerd, so you're always gonna hear some nerd pop references when I talk. But you know, I feel like when you watch Star Wars, you know, it's not about the Empire, you know what I'm saying? The Star Wars, you watch the movie, it's about the Rebellion, you know what I'm saying? You see Luke, you see Leia, you see Han, and right now when you turn on the news, all you see is Vader, 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 Vader all day, you know what I'm saying? It's like, splat, you know, let's showcase the people who's out here doing something and making a difference, you know? Opposed to just all the evil all the time, it's just whack, you know? People need something positive.
Okay, so... Speaking on movies, what are your like top three political movies that you would suggest or recommend someone?
Political movies right now?
Like, you know.
this movie called Good Luck, Good Night. It's about how this one reporter took on McCarthy, who was doing the whole thing when he was trying to make everybody out to be a communist and things like that. It's a very, very good movie. It has a lot of good stars. It's an indie film. It's in black and white. It's very talkative, but very educational. I recommend anybody read that any day. I watch that any day of the week. Trust me on that. Y'all love it. Yeah.
Was that three? How many
are you gonna do? Nah, just two. I mean, like just I told you, I was trying.
All right, so favorite sci-fi movies, B? What are those?
A sci-fi movie?
Sci-fi.
Oh, come on, man.
We need to get in the D-rec. Like, what is like, oh my God, this is the best. You need to see this movie if you didn't see it yet.
You seen Upgrade?
Nope.
You gotta see Upgrade, man. That movie was the sleeper hit last year, man. That movie is insanity. I can't even tell you. Maybe as I'm talking about this, maybe I'll cut in pieces of the trailer so people can actually see what I'm talking about here, you know, when I edit this together, you know. But I'm telling you, that movie is dope. That movie is real dope. And I'm so shocked that so many people didn't see that movie, but it's really, really good. Really good, you know. Top all around sci-fi movie for me. All right, Matrix, obviously. You know what I'm saying? Who don't like the Matrix? You gotta just love how they pull that whole story together. Terminator 2, without a doubt, is one of the greatest movies ever made. As far as I'm concerned, as far as sci-fi is concerned, I always love how James Cameron managed to tell you the story, and he tells it on the move while action is going on. So you're not just sitting there getting crazy expedition dialogue all day. I can't stand that in movies, you know. But he executes that as well. You know, as you can see in Avatar, all his films, he always do a good job, even in Titanic. And Dad, I don't want to sound like a Cameron horror, man. It's kind of hard, man, because I know Aliens come to mind too, you know what I'm saying? Because that's mad influential. So yeah, if I'm a Cameron whore, I'm a Cameron whore. I love James Cameron films, man. Man, do it right as far as I'm concerned, you know?
It is what it is. Mm-hmm.